The Refuge by Ray Lowe.
For this, after this.
You have always known of this house. Have always been invited here where you will remember the exposed beams, the honey-colored wide plank floors, skylights for light of moon, stars, and sun, well-worn tables for the drying of herbs and the making of tinctures. This refuge exists beyond time and portals those who enter here into ancient forms of knowing. The movement of stars, prayers for all beings, blossoms, roots, leaves, the gift of understanding the speech of animals, plants, even whole mountains. The ancient ones taught us to come here for strengthening, showing us the uses of gold thread for infection, chamomile rising up through sand and stone, bringing calm and wisdom. Rose petals for jam or syrup, spirit food in times of sadness or doubt. Looking up, you would see sweet-smelling bundles of nettle and lemon balm for swelling, endurance, and digestion. The grandmothers and grandfathers invite us here to dance, to meet each other as reflections of our own selves, and in the end, to become full and complete human beings. There is no fee for coming to this magical cabin, simply the donation of humility and the willingness to step into the innocent splendor of the roses, the irises, the lilies, in their short and ecstatic dance on the living stage of this enchanted and priceless earth.
It's starting.
Fisher. Thanks. It's cucumber lemon water.
Thank you.
Inversnaid by Gerard Manley Hopkins. This darksome burn, horseback brown, his roll rock high road roaring down, in coop and in comb the fleece of his foam, flutes and low to the lake falls home. A wind-puff bonnet of fawn froth turns and twindles over the broth of a pool so pitch black, fell frawning, it rounds and rounds despair to drowning. Dagged with dew, dappled with dew, are the groins of the braes that the brook treads through. Wiry heat packs, flitches of ferns, and the bead bonny ash that sits over the burn. What would the world be, once bereft of wet and of wildness? Let them be left. Oh, let them be left, wildness and wet. Long live the weeds and the wilderness yet. Theodore Rothke wrote Long Live the Weeds after this poem by Hopkins. Long live the weeds that overwhelm my narrow vegetable realm, the bitter rock, the barren soil that forced the Son of Man to toil, all things unholy, marked by curse, the ugly of the universe, the rough, the wicked, and the wild that keep the spirit undefiled. With these I match my little wit and earn the right to stand or sit. Hope, look, create, or drink and die. These shape the creature that is I.
Thank you. Remember the sky that you were born under. Know each of the star stories. Remember the moon. Know who she is. Remember the sun's birth at dawn. That is the strongest point in time. Remember sundown and giving away tonight. Remember your birth, how your mother struggled to give you form and breath. You are evidence of her life and her mother's and hers. Remember your father, he is your life also. Remember the earth whose skin you are. Red earth, black earth, yellow earth, white earth, brown earth, we are earth. Remember the plants, trees, animal life, all who have their own tribes, their families, their histories too. Talk to them. Listen to them. They are alive poems. Remember the wind. Remember her voice. She knows the origin of this universe. Remember, you are all people, and all people are you. Remember, you are this universe, and this universe is you. Remember, all is in motion, is growing, is you. Remember, language comes from this. Remember the dance languages that life is. Remember.